I was clear when he started to act funny. Honey's wanna hit, so that started trap for me. Imagine what it's gonna be when I get this rap money. Looking up to whoever was known for cooking up. You could be taken in, you could be taken up. Stand firm like a man, never get shook enough. I swear you can make it. Just look at us, what goes around comes around again. Know the same rules apply from now to then.
Right now, Chef Tarik in the house. Hold on, hold on. Oh, it smells delicious.
We gotta bring it back. We gotta bring it back.
Oh, it smells delicious in here.
Oh yeah, we live. We ready to go, baby. Oh yeah.
I'm gonna stop.
It's early. Let me know how good. It's been a long weekend already. But ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to a new episode of Mixing Up with Chef Tarik. I'm your host, Chef Tarik, of course. Well, today we have DJ Johnny Steelo in the building today. How are you doing today?
I'm very hungry.
Look, listen. We also got this nice, beautiful apron.
I gotta check this out.
Look, if you're not seeing the theme of it, it's Breast Cancer Awareness Month, ladies and gentlemen. You see, I got my pink Chef Tarik apron on. You see the pink and black breast cancer aprons. You already know those are for sale, of course. October 17th, join us for the Breast Cancer Walk, downtown Providence. Starts around like 8 o'clock, but we're going to be down there. We'll be doing a show down there as well, so we will be live while we're walking. So that will be our episode for that day. But hey, we got a lot of things planned for you today. Today we are making Swedish meatballs. Johnny Steele, you ever had Swedish meatballs?
Never. I seen it on TV, though, I can't lie.
Yeah.
Was that Channel 2?
Channel 2?
Yeah, they was chefing it up, and I was like, what?
It's gonna be a good episode. Look, I'm ready for this. Look, it's a good episode. This is a long time
ago. They were homemade too. I came by yesterday. I seen you chefing it all the
way up. Yeah, see?
Listen, it was different yesterday. The smell difference was crazy. Yesterday was crazy.
Yo, yeah. It was Friday. It's been a long weekend. Friday when we did the taste test, he came right in when I was finishing up, just prep. Yo. He's gonna be a good one, so.
I don't wanna spoil it.
But look, we got a good episode for y'all. We're gonna get it going. See, let's get the tunes going. Let's get it.
Oh, yeah. Time to cook up. Little bit of R&B instrumental, why not? We staying Instagram friendly. Hold on, let's do this. Something different. I know they wanna get that Sade, though.
First thing, Johnny Steele, I got a question for you. Do you know where Swedish meatballs are from?
Not from Sweden.
Exactly. He got that right. I was ready to get him with that one. Yes. So Swedish meatballs are not from Sweden. They are from Turkey, actually. Yeah. So it originated back in the 18th centuries from King Charles the 12th. When he brought it back from a recipe that he had before, so that's where it originally started from, was Turkey. Of course, he brought it to Europe and Sweden and stuff like that as well. Yeah. So what makes Swedish meatballs so different from regular meatballs of any kind is that they use different spices. So we're using allspice, we're using nutmeg, we're using the spices in them. And then in Swedish meatballs, we're also using pork and ground beef as well, I'm saying it. But, so it's pork, it's ground pork and ground beef together, which is about 50-50, instead of always using regular beef with, Parmesan and stuff like that, Italian meatballs. Swedish meatballs have pork, ground beef in them as well with the spices. So that's what's gonna be a little bit different about today's meatballs. Instead of using spaghetti, we are gonna use egg noodles, different type of noodles, and we're gonna use a different type of sauce. And that sauce, you seen the other day, that sauce was crazy.
Listen. I don't know, we need to do a DIY for YouTube.
And look, if you guys already know, all these episodes do go up on YouTube if you guys ever want to see them as well after the show. But what we're going to start off with sweating some onions and garlic. Now, are you a fan of vegetables?
Oh, yeah.
What's some of your favorite vegetables you eat?
My favorite vegetable is asparagus. Favorite first go with
asparagus.
Yeah.
Okay.
Gotta get the lettuce. Love my onions, carrots. Oh man, pickles.
Pickles? Yeah, okay.
Cucumber pickle thing.
Nice.
I just became a fan of tomatoes, I can't lie.
Really?
31 years to get accustomed to that fruit thing.
Yes. Tomatoes are fruit, everyone, so if you don't know that. But yeah, that's actually interesting.
But actually, what made you want to become a DJ? What made you get into this field?
Oh man, I love music. My passion for music is a little, it's like on the Albert Einstein side of things. Like, I'm really weird with music. It's like, I get into the science, math, the history.
Yeah.
So if you used to drop a song, I pretty much finally get social by the end of the week. I'm obsessed with this. But 13 years old, picked it up as a hobby, then I found out I can make some money, and I make people smile, relieve some stress, and it just became like a habit.
Look, see, look, I told y'all, season 3, we get new DJs, new food, new taste sessions. Look, new stories you get to hear all the time. This is what I like about it. You get to see new dishes, you get to hear new things from everybody.
All right, so right now, we have our just onions and garlic just cooking a little bit. We don't have to cook these all the way, so we're going to turn the flame off on that. And we're going to get started with our meatballs. So we're going to use ground pork. We're going to use ground beef. Now we're also going to add in 2 eggs as a stabilizer to help hold everything in place, make sure everything is tight, sticks together. We're gonna add in our breadcrumbs. Just a touch of milk. We don't need that much milk because we have the eggs and the breadcrumbs in it already. That's gonna hold the meatballs together. We'll add in some parsley. Now we're gonna season this with some, we're gonna add some Lowry seasoning. Now we're gonna add in some allspice to give it that Swedish flavor. Well, actually that Turkish flavor. We're gonna add in some nutmeg.
What?
You heard what I said. These kids will come.
All right, so you've seen the show before. Your first time on the show.
I can't do it.
I'm using natural spices over here, and I still get AO. Like, come on.
We're gonna add some salt to it as well. Some pepper. We're also gonna add in our onions and garlic. What are they saying in the chat?
Nothing.
They acting up already?
Yeah, on my account.
Look, they catfishing Chef Drewski over here.
That it's not me on my phone, guys.
All right, so we're also gonna add in, right before we mix it, we're gonna add just a little bit of Worcestershire sauce as well. And now we're just gonna mix everything together. Now normally I'll just kinda like, just press on it just a little bit. Now we want to just keep pressing just to make sure everything is folded in and incorporated properly. If we need to add more seasoning, we'll add that to it.
I get so
add just a little bit of Lowry's, just a little bit of salt, just to add, just to get everything else incorporated. Add a little bit more allspice. Now we are just gonna test it out just to make sure that our seasonings is up to standard of the par. Now no, when you're making about like meatballs or anything that you're grounding together, it's always good to take a small piece of it to try it out, just to make sure that your seasoning is there, it's not a little too salty, if you need to add something to it. So we're just gonna test it out, just a small piece, just to make sure it's good to go. Now, Johnny Steelo, when you have meatballs, you know, what's your ideal kind of flavors to it, you know?
Regular old Fed Hill. This is new to me.
Yeah?
This is very new to me. Because, yeah. Like, you know, I'm Dominican and Puerto Rican, so we got, like, meatballs, but they super dry. They usually go with rice. We don't really do the noodle thing with the meatballs. That's foreign to us. So, this is interesting. I don't know. I don't want to spoil it for y'all. But, yo, the way these meatballs are, I just never seen a meatball like that. I only seen it with the rice sauce. So,
yeah.
We had something else going on over here. It was fire.
Now, also, what's some of, like, you know, your favorite meals you normally eat? What's something like your go-to?
I'm a straight New York, you know, pizza, Chinese food. Yeah, home-cooked meals is two.
Are you originally from New York?
I was born here. Lived out there. Kept going to school out here. So it was back and forth.
Back and forth.
All right. And then I traveled a lot because of DJing. So I got to, like, taste other foods elsewhere. So then I come back here and it's like, it's just not the same. I mean, certain foods. But the Caribbean food out here, it's fire.
Yeah.
But it's just like, how much Caribbean? I want, like, a good burger. Like, you know, like something different.
Yeah.
When you go to Seattle and eat a burger, it's just a different experience. It's a heavy, heavy piece of thing. You can buy the chow down, the rest is over here. You ain't at Wendy's. IHOP, you know, Red Robin, like, you need a burger franchise. I never been to Shake Shack though. What's the other?
Shake Shack.
There's a Bun Burger, something like
there's
that.
There's Tasty Bug Burger, Wahlburgers. That's yeah. That's in Boston from the Mark Wahlberg family. There's
Five Guys.
In-N-Out, Five Guys. What's the
Five Guys?
You're not a Five Guys fan?
Nah.
Five Guys, fire.
I rock with Five Guys.
I've already tasted some other places before.
That's right, yeah.
Too many fries.
Now, you say you go back and forth from New York around. I gotta ask though, you a Yankee fan?
Mets fan.
Oh, no.
Different, yeah.
Oh, no.
Yankees is just, I don't know.
You know what? I was gonna make a joke if you was a Yankee fan, but you know what? It's okay. You're a Mets fan. I'm fine with Mets fans.
Yeah, Yankee fans are different.
I went to the game a couple weeks ago, Red Sox Mets at Fenway. Game was fire. We won, of course, big dogs. But you know what? It was a good crowd. I like Mets fans. Yankee fans? No.
It's different. Yeah, them Red Sox Yankee games were different.
Oh yeah. I'm all right. So we just took a taste of it. We're gonna add just a tad bit more salt. Just get that mixed in again. And then we're gonna get these rolled out on our tray and start cooking them all. So, another thing about Swedish meatballs is that they're normally smaller in size than regular meatballs. You know, you get, you know, pretty big ones, you know, pretty good sized meatballs, like Italian meatballs or whatever. Swedish meatballs are like really, normally pretty small, so you'll get a lot out of a batch that you're working with, and you'll just see just in like a few scoops that will have like 20 of these in like a heartbeat. So especially when you're scooping out, you always want to remember to just kind of like scrape off so you get the perfect form on there. You can just see with just this scoop, we're just already getting a lot of product out of our meatballs. And there's still a whole bunch more, so we can always save this for later if we're not gonna use them all. So we're gonna set this one to the sides, use that for later. Now, also just going to just roll them into little balls. Also, I gotta say, shout out to my boy John, James, and their whole catering group, the Swells Party. Man, me and Drewski went out there last night for a gig in, Lennox, Mass.
Yeah, Berkshires.
Berkshires, man. A great event, great team down there. Appreciate you guys. Thank you for having us. It was a great event. Tiring, my feet hurt still, but it was a great event. Well, we're just gonna roll these out. Now, Johnny Steelo, I do have a DJ question, musically wise. So, you know, we talked to a few other DJs, and I talked to DJ Matic, asked him this same question last week. When you're in the club or you're at parties, do you normally make like a playlist? You know, what's your
form? Oh, no playlist.
You don't make a playlist? Why?
I read people. I don't know if I was told, I just learned at an early age how to read people.
Read the crowd.
Walk in the club, see 1,000 people, and I'm reading each individual. Like, all right, this is what you want to listen to, this is what you want to listen to, and this is what you want to listen to on your way home.
Yep.
And I can do that like very fast. And I can tell, like, I can give you a whole Spotify playlist just by like type, like looking at you, like, all right, cool, all right, this is what you like, all right, this is where you from, all right, cool, this is where you dress, all right, you from here, oh, you speak this way, all right, cool, I know exactly where to play. And that just comes from like being in, like, it's not nothing good. Like, you learn this from being in the worst case scenario. Like, all right, you in a party in Brooklyn, you're playing a specific person from New York that you're not supposed to play. And then you just, like, you have to learn that. Like,
yo, you're being down south.
Yeah, like, yeah, it's just be, ooh, I seen worst of the worst happen. Yeah.
Now, what's your, like, style of music? Are you big on hip hop? You know, reggae?
Well, it's different because my upbringing, Latin, Spanish was my first language, right? So I obviously knew all my Spanish music. You know what I'm saying? Got these two freaking parents. One's from an island, the other one's from New York. My dad's an 80s baby to the T. So it'll be rock and roll, early hip hop, jazz music. So I got all that like embedded. And then my mom's Dominican, so she know like the merengue, bachata, and that's pretty much it. She's like from like the hood out there, like, you know what I'm saying? From the 70s and all that. So she know a lot of old school 70s records, 60 records, you know, like all that mafia music was pretty much big out there.
Yeah.
And then, so I got like a weird taste for music. Like, it's just, I can literally listen to everything. Like, it's just.
You have a good mix of, like, oh, I can put this in and turn that around.
I'll show you a little example, like, with a couple of these remixes I got here. You can see, like, damn, this dude, how you mix that? That's it.
Yeah.
You know, like, it's just.
And you had, like, a lot of blends in there, a lot of, like,
yeah, I got beats. A lot of blends. I just won the Rhode Island Blend Champion thing, so like I've been trying to like become.
Oh, congrats on that!
Yeah,
oh,
I'm trying to do like, you know, I know y'all know the game DJ Hero. I want to do like a trash version of that for the PS5.
All
you
right,
so yeah, so I actually got the job at the mall, at the VR Zone, and we're developing an app where you can DJ on the head. It's crazy. I'm coming for the head soon.
Oh, I like that.
All right.
Look, all you DJs, look, when that app come out, y'all gonna have to get on that one.
VR DJ.
I can actually get it now, too.
Yeah? Also, what's the name of the app?
It's like DJ VR.
DJ VR. Look, DJ VR is on an Oculus, so if you got an Oculus, make sure you got download the app, see what you guys can do on it. Look,
this kid already wants to go get his Oculus and go do it himself. He thinks he's a DJ. He's a DJ in training. That's what he is.
We need to make a cooking one like that. Virtual cooking.
That would be lit. I like that. Look at that. We're going to be in touch with the building on that one. I like that one.
All right, so we're going to get our meatballs in the pan. And now we're just going to fry them off, just to get them seared off, just very quickly. What are they saying in the chat?
Just talking about how they always wanted to be DJs and stuff.
Oh, see, you got the chat saying they want to be DJs and stuff.
They're telling your mom to get on the virtual cooking show.
Damn, what y'all trying to say about her? You trying to say she can't cook or something? She needs lessons?
Ooh.
Look at that.
Look, I didn't say it, they did. Now you can just see the color of the meatballs. Great browning on one side. And just a great browning on the other side. We're gonna take these out and we're gonna finish, let them go in the oven to finish off before then we're gonna start our sauce. Get those in the oven. These are going in at 375. Now with our pan, we still have it on. So now we're gonna make our gravy cream sauce. So basically we're gonna make it gravies, which is gonna be a roux plus either chicken broth, beef broth, veg stock, whatever you have.
People remember what the word roux is.
Look, yeah, it's three seasons in. Y'all better know what roux is. I want to see what y'all say about roux in the chat. But Johnny Steelo, do you know what a roux is?
I do not.
You not know what a roux is? So, I'll give the answer now, but everyone else in the chat better know it. So, what a roux is basically equal parts flour, equal parts fat. So, it's basically a thickening agent. So, what we're doing is we have our oil from the meatballs. We just added a little bit of butter. And we're just gonna add in a little bit of some flour. And we're just going to get it mixed together. Now if you have more flour than fat, you can always add, and vice versa as well.
Yeah, they said it's flour and butter, they got it.
Oh, okay, y'all remember y'all been paying attention? Okay.
Bookie said, isn't it carrot, onion, and celery?
Who said that?
Bookie.
Bookie, come on. Stop trolling these people, you know better.
We just want our flour to just get mixed in with our fat.
Now we're going to add our stock.
Without you, baby. Still on my own, my
Your mom said she's gonna tell the culinary institute.
See, Bookie? Now you got her going. She don't think you ain't go there or nothing like that. Like you wasn't with us nothing in the kitchen, the fundies and stuff. Like,
come on. But now we got our broth in here. We have it mixing with our roux. We're gonna keep our heat on about medium to high. And you can already start seeing it incorporating with our roux starting to thicken up. And if it's too thick, you can always add more as well. Now the big thing with being making a roux when you're adding it to soups or sauces, you don't want the flour to be really clumpy, so you want to make sure the flour is out of it. So you just want to just keep giving it a stir, just let it incorporate with the fat, incorporate with the stock or the broth or which one you're using. So you can see the flour is dissolved, it's mixed in with the fat. We'll add just a little bit more stock, and then we're gonna add our cream and our seasonings in it as well. Now, Johnny Steelo, are you a fan of gravy?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, what do you normally have it with?
A lot. Actually, gravy is used a lot in my culture. Dominican and Puerto Rican, they use it pretty much for everything. You know what I'm saying? You take the sauce, put over the beans, rice, mashed potatoes. That was new to me. That was a crazy experience. When I first had mashed potatoes and gravy, bro, I kid you not, it came from KFC. I was like 11 years old. First time I had KFC, bro. Yo, I gotta find that VHS and upload that. That was a crazy experience. I don't know, that was different.
I don't know, yeah,
that's
different.
So you see our gravy is nice and thick. We're gonna add a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper. Now we're gonna add in our egg noodles. Now egg noodles will cook pretty fast, so they don't have to cook that low, so that's why we're adding this towards the end, basically.
What are egg noodles, Chef?
What are egg noodles? What's the difference between egg and rice noodles?
Oh no, oh no.
So, I'm not gonna lie. I don't know, and I don't know. You know what? It'd be a rare moment y'all actually stumped me on this show, and that was a good one. You know what? Egg noodles basically is it's the same thing if you're making regular pasta dough, and it's just the form of basically the pasta you're using, basically. So it's basically just kind of rolled up. It's a different way of, like, you have rigatonis, your spaghettis, your fettuccine.
Show the people.
So it's just basically like a different, it's just like a different style of pasta. So you can see like they kind of twist it a little bit, and it's really thin. So, I mean, that's the best answer I can honestly give you guys. And with rice noodles are thinner, and I don't actually think they use egg.
Rice paper.
Rice noodles is rice paper. So,
So it's not a form of pasta like noodles, like with regular dough.
Yeah.
But it's a different way of like cutting it up and stuff like that. I don't know. That's the best I can give you guys right now. I'm kind of mad that I'm pretty stumped right now. I don't know. I don't know. Look, see, even the best chefs get stumped sometimes. I learned some things too. I don't know everything.
But now we have our gravy.
Get this kid off.
We're gonna add in our heavy cream.
Your mom's disappointed. She's
What did she say?
She said, I'm disappointed. I'm so disappointed.
Hey,
I'm here to tell you. I don't care.
It happens. I get stumped. It's okay.
Chef Tarik, I have a question.
Oh, God. Here comes this one. What do you want?
What is that white stuff you put in?
I put heavy cream in here.
Oh, okay.
I just said that. What's the problem?
Nothing. Just had to ask.
It's cream. I can't do anything. Y'all on me today too. Y'all, I can't do anything. It's food, people. It's food. What do you want me to do?
We gotta be a DJ. We gotta be nice.
That don't mean nothing to them.
We're just gonna keep. We're just gonna let our cream just incorporate with our gravy right now. Now, before y'all even ask, our pasta water is salted. You always should salt your pasta water. So you can just see how creamy this is already. Now we're gonna let this just come up to just a quick simmer, and then we'll turn this off. We're also gonna just taste it just to make sure our seasoning's correct in there as well. We'll just add a tad bit of salt in there. Into our sauce. We're just gonna get them incorporated. And at this point, my flame is off on the sauce. As our pasta noodles is finishing up, we're just gonna clean up our station, get our plating area set ready to go. We have our parsley for our garnish.
Johnny Steelo, look, come taste this sauce. Taste the sauce.
Yo, that's the same thing as left, yo. Bugging. Bugging right now. Might not leave for work now.
Now our egg noodles.
We'll go about 5 pieces of meatballs on our egg noodles. Now we're just gonna drizzle our sauce all around, right on top. Add just a little bit of Parmesan.
You gotta do the motions, cameraman.
Top it off with our parsley right on top. Sheesh! I does this.
I don't have a gift. I've been moving state to state in my leather and my Timbs like it's 1998. And my dog Chubby Chub, that's my from the way on the east side of the city. That's where everybody stay. Seem like everybody call it cause they want me in the song.
It's like, well, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Like always, I does this. We have our Swedish meatballs with our garlic, creamy, gravy, not garlic, you know what I mean. They ready to eat. It's time to go.
We're gonna
bring this over to DJ Johnny Steelo.
Listen here.
Hey, whoa.
Now we're also gonna bring this over to our taste tester.
Everybody in the building.
Oh yeah, we got my boy Cam here in the building.
Come on.
Go ahead and taste.
Again. I'm gonna need a plate to go. For sure.
How's it? What do you think of it though?
10 out of 10.
Yeah?
For sure.
Look at that. Look, DJ Johnny Steelo, what you think?
Yeah, he ain't lying. Couple to go plates. When's the restaurant opening? We need to order that.
Look.
Presentation is A1, though, I can't even lie. Mm-hmm. That was fast for some presentation.
You got a proposition in the chat.
Oh, uh-oh. Well, what they saying in the chat?
How about a virtual versus you and Bookie?
Ooh. Who said that?
Bookie.
Oh, hold on. So, wait a minute. Let me get this straight. Bookie, let me get this straight. I call you on my show every week to come on and do a show with me, because we brothers. But now you want to challenge me. This is...
You can do a three-peat.
You know
in the
what?
Kitchen, barbecue on the grill, and a late night snack.
Hey, that's not...
Oh, I'll be here.
You know what?
I'll be here.
You know what? Hey, Bookie, you get a DJ... You get your apron. Let's get it. Challenge accepted, my brother. Let's get it going.
Virtual history.
Look, we can do it virtually. We can do it here. We can do it any. Look, we go Maryland. Trip to Maryland. Look, we've been there before. I'm with it.
Ooh.
Look.
You see everybody's face in the room. I said, whoa, what?
He called you out. You a buster. You know
that beat Chef Tarik.
Mm-hmm.
Tell him.
Let's tell him.
You're not gonna win. Are you serious? Serious?
Damn, why you like got my chest like that, though?
God damn. Yo, we spent that out of my back in my chest. Well, yo, hey, Bookie, you serious about this? We here every Sunday, 11 a.m. You want a challenge? We doing a challenge. Wherever you want to do it at, we doing it at. Online, Maryland, Providence, let's get it. I'm here for it.
You can do it on Instagram, half and half.
Half and half?
Or we can go to Maryland.
No, look, my team's ready to go. They thinking of ideas. You saying Maryland?
You ain't playing no games, book.
Look, you not playing no games. Yo,
this is real.
That'll be different.
Stop playing with us. We Chef Tarik.
Look,
word.
Like, y'all forward on this.
Look, exactly. You hearing it? We not scared over here. This is what we do. We does this, Bookie. You know this. You know me. You know my name. You see the logo. You see what's behind me. We do this every weekend. You know that.
They said Jack Harlow in the building, bro.
I cannot get over that, bro. That.
How am I going to get disrespected? I'm a guest.
Hey, but look, Bookie, we're going to set that up. We're going to set that challenge up, definitely. Find you a DJ? We're going to be here. I'm with it. I don't care if we have to have two DJs. We gon'
that would be fine.
He said he'll have his team hit your team with details.
Look, I'm here for it. Look.
Oh man,
look, ladies and gentlemen, on that note, that is the end of our show. DJ Johnny Steelo, thank you for coming on.
Thank you for having me. This is definitely this is the craziest introduction to the fall of my life.
Yeah.
This.
What?
What? Babe, where you at? You gotta learn how to make this. This is different.
Oh no, let's not get her in trouble.
Oh yeah, now she's tasting this right now.
Look, we definitely gotta get you back on the show. Love having you on here, so we're definitely gonna get you back soon. Let me know where you're gonna be at, any clubs you're gonna be at, parties.
I'm all over the world. I don't even like to explain. Just follow me at Johnny Steelo Instagram, YouTube. Mm-hmm. You said you got a YouTube now. I see the Chef Tarik on the YouTube.
You see it.
Boom, you just type it in, subscribe, show love, drop a comment. Make sure you drop them comments. Show us love. Let us know if we should do this again, battling, calling people out. This might be like a once a month thing. We might have to make it an event.
Look, y'all said it. I just shouted out my boys Jamie and Johns from Swell's catering group. We might have to battle them next too.
Ooh.
We might have to maybe get them on the show to do something.
Yeah, Halloween's coming up too. It might be interesting.
It's spooky season. We getting challenges. You already know what we're doing. But yes, follow us on YouTube, Chef Tarik, subscribe to the channel, The Kid Show, Chef Tarik Show. Every Wednesday, 5 p.m. What are you doing? You trying to eat, kid?
Mm-hmm.
It's everybody.
It's that good, bro. We can't lie.
But yes, 5 p.m. Chef Tarik Show, Junior's Edition. If you want your kids to come on the show, let's get your kids on the show as well.
Oh, Kids Edition. That would be crazy.
Yes,
I got myself. That's already.
Look, when your kids get a little bit older, look, get them on the show. You already know.
Get them on the show, get more Chef Tarik food, right?
Exactly. And look, when he made that challenge, he said, yo, YouTube vlog, yo, we already got some vlogs on there already. Look, we got our New York trip. My cousin's wedding and the Top Cheese episode.
Mm.
We got
cheese.
Oh yeah, that episode was crazy.
I didn't see that.
We got a few other things we recorded. A mixing up Chef Tarik when the anniversary episode is out also as well. Our vlog for that, so you guys can check that out.
And look, if he comes down, we vlogging on that one. We going crazy for that episode. We going
book pack.
We smoking on that book packs over here. That's what we doing.
Oh
book
wow.
Pack.
Oh wow.
Give the baby test.
But yes, before we even go close it out, also October. That's all I'm about to say. Thank you for reminding me. October 17th, breast cancer walk, breast cancer awareness, downtown Providence, Kennedy Plaza. October 17th, 8 a.m. That will be our mixed up stretching episode. You see our aprons, you see our t-shirts, you see the gibbets as well. We still have our gibbets for sale. So go get your Chef Tarik gibbets for breast cancer month. Our Chef Tarik breast cancer awareness shirt as well. Join the team, donate. The link is in my bio and on Facebook as well. So you guys can go donate to that as well. So please donate. Look, I wanna raise over $400 this year. We raised over $300, I wanna get to over $400. So let's do that, let's keep it going. Thank you to everyone that's already donated so far. Look, ladies and gentlemen, that is our show. We ended up on a crazy note. Bookie, you better be ready for this. I don't wanna hear no capping from you now. You put it out in the universe, put it in the chat. Look, Johnny Steelo don't hurt it. He said he ready for it. He want to see that.
Called out my whole company, man.
Yeah, yeah. You don't put the team on the line. Look, we ready to go now. Look, don't play us now. But yes, look, ladies and gentlemen, that is our show for today. Thank you guys for watching. Have a great Sunday. Also, let's go Pats.
Let's go Bucks.
Beat the Bucks.
Let's go Bucks.
Breaks over Tom Brady. He's not a Patriot no more. I don't care what anyone says.
Let's go Bucks. Patriots.
But yes, ladies and gentlemen, that is our show. DJ Johnny Steelo, let's take us out of here.
Let's get us out of here.
Book back, coming soon, you know the vibe.